Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Now today we'll be looking at postulum of cone and pyramid in mathematics. Postulum of cone and pyramid in mathematics. Then the last week I taught you how to compute the surface area and volume of a cone and how to compute the volume of a pyramid. Now let me just do a brief revision of that. This is a cone on the board. And example of a cone is a funnel. Funnel is a form of cone and some part of some ice cream. Some ice cream are in form of cone. Now, then if the cone is turned down or is turned upside down, it will look like this, Sabi. Now what's been the first one? A pyramid. So that is a cone, and this is a pyramid on the board. Look at the pyramid. This is a pyramid. Can you see now? This is what we call a pyramid. And I want to tell you the meaning of first form of a cone. Look at what I wrote on the board. If a cone or pyramid is cut off, the top part is called a smaller cone. Can you see now? This is a cone. Let's assume this cone is cut off. Let's say it's cut off from here. If it is cut off from here. Can you see it now? If it is cut off, what will happen? You will have a smaller cone. This is a smaller cone. Can you see that? Then, and this is a bigger cone. From here to here is what is bigger cone, Abi? The bigger cone. And this is a what? First form of a cone. Let me write it outside like this. First form of a cone. Can you see now? Then this is a what? Smaller cone. And from here to here is the bigger cone. Hope you can see now. So whenever a cone is cut off, so the top part, the top part is smaller cone. Sorry. Let's say this is the cone here. Let me start from here. So this is the top part, is the what? Smaller cone. Here the cone is turned upside down. The smaller cone. Point to what I got on the board. And the other part is first tune. This is the first tune of the cone. Okay, when it is turned upside down, this will be the what? Smaller cone. Everything here is the bigger cone, and this is the first tune of the cone. The one that is cut off. The remaining one, right? If I what? If I clean this side now, let me clean it now. Can you see now? First tune of the cone. So, a bucket is an example of what? First tune. So, whenever you what? A cone is cut off. So, the one, this one, it will form a first tune of a cone. Can you see it now? This is a complete cone. Can you see now? So, for your note, try to write this topic, then write this, then diagram. It's very important. Then, let's move to the first tune of a pyramid. This is a pyramid on the board. If I cut it off from here, like this, can you see now? I've cut it off. What happened? Then the top is what? Is the smaller pyramid. Can you see now? And the what? And this value, that if this is cut off, this will be the first tune of the pyramid. Can you see now? So then after by clean this one off now, I've cut it off. See what will happen. So this was called first tomb of the pyramid. Can you see now? First tomb of the pyramid. Hope that is clear to you. Is that clear? So try to draw this diagram. It's very, very important. And let's look at this example on the board. Find the capacity in liters of a bucket 24 cm in diameter at the top, 60 cm in diameter at the bottom, and 20 cm deep. But to find capacity in bucket, let's draw the bucket on the board. The bucket is like this. Let me draw it. This is the bucket. It should be like this. You want to draw this diagram, please use your pencil. Don't use pen to draw a diagram for me. Use your pencil to make your work to be neat. Hope you can see it. I've drawn a pocket on the board for you. Now, then, you have to find the capacity of the bucket. 24 centimeters in diameter at the top. This is the top of the bucket. This is the bottom of the bucket. So the diameter from here to here, 24 centimeters. Can you see it? But I don't want to write diameter here. Let's write the radius. From here to here is the radius. So from the center of the circle to the circumference, to what? To the part of the circumference is called the radius. And now calculate the radius. Don't mean that's what? Radius is equal to what? Radius is equal to what? Diameter over. Exactly, you now. Then that will be what? 24 divided by 2. That gives us 12 centimeters. So this will be what? 12 centimeters. I mean, then the diameter, 60 centimeters in diameter at bottom. Bottom will be bucket from here to here, 60 centimeters. I mean, can you see now? But me, I don't want to write it. I want to put radius here. I will tell you the reason. So from here to here, with the radius. So capital letter R represent the radius of the bigger circle. Small letter R represent the radius of the smaller circle here. Can you see now? So that will be what? And D. Small letter D represent the diameter. Hey, yeah, I'm not trying to see. Sorry. This is the working on the word. Capital letter R represent the radius of the bigger circle. Then small letter and capital letter represent the diameter of the bigger circle. So radius got what diameter divided by 2. So diameter of the what? Of the in the diameter of the at the top is 24 centimeter. But I want to write the radius here, so I have to divide it by 2. So that's why I'll get 12. And this one too, diameter of the bottom is 20 is 16. I have to divide it by 2 and that gives us what? 8. So I'm trying to write the working on the board here. We need to see clearly. Look at the working. Hope you can get it. Hope you can get it. So diameter of the smaller cone will be what? I will be saying so. Diameter of this small circle, that will be what? 1 over 2. And that gives us 12 over 2. And that gives us, no, that gives us 16 over 2. And that gives us 8 centimeters. That is clear to you now. Is that clear? Good. I can even write it here. So I can write it here. Don't worry, don't write it here. I can write it here. That is 1 over 2. That is 24 over 2. That is what there. So the tower is what? So the tower is what? That is what? That is what? 16 over 2. That is what?
Hope that is clear. Then, and the at the bottom and 20 centimeter deep. Deep means how the height of the bucket. How deep is this? Is that the height? Deep means what? Height of the bucket. How deep is this? Where is the height of the bucket? Have you? This is the height. So deep means height of the bucket. How tall it is? That is what 20 centimeter. Can you see that? But now something. I want to do something here. Can you see that? Then we have to find the volume of the what? Now before I find the we have to find the capacity in liters. Before you can find capacity in liters, you have to find the volume of the what of a solid shape. What's the meaning of volume? The amount of space the what the solid shape can occupy. So after finding the volume of that shape, then we will convert it to liters. So the first thing is you have to find the volume of the what of the shape. And when you can find the volume of the shape, look at this diagram bucket. Want to find? You have to extend it to what? To a cone. Extend it to make it a what? A cone. I've extended it. Can you see now? After extending it, I'm having a smaller cone. From here to a smaller cone, then bigger cone. Then here be this height of the smaller cone. And I've used small letter H to represent the height of the smaller cone. And this one will be the radius of the smaller cone. This one will be the what? Radius of the bigger cone. Can you see now? So from here to here, from here to here is 20. From here to here, let me write it here. I will use capital letter H to represent the height of the bigger cone. I will use small letter H to represent the height of the smaller cone. Then, from here to here is 60. I mean, can you see now? What is that to you? Then, how can you find the volume of this bucket? Which is bucket is the same as the volume of a cone. The volume of the volume
posture of the womb.
Is it called to what? How to write the formula?
It will give us volume of the bigger womb. Okay, volume of the big womb. Then it is volume of the big womb minus volume of the small cone.
Oh, that is clear to you now. Volume of the big cone minus volume of the small cone. So the volume of the big cone here, you subtract the volume of the small cone from it, it will give you the volume of the first two. So you take away the volume of this, you take away this what? Volume of the what? This smaller cone from this bigger cone. It will, the remaining is, what will remain is what? Will be the first two of the cone, that is the bucket. Then volume of a big cone. Look at that what? Volume of a cone is what? Is 1 over 3 by half square h.
Then, you know what happened now here?
Yeah. I use capital letter R to represent radius of the bigger cone. Capital letter H to represent what? Height of the bigger cone. Then minus volume of the smaller cone. Of the small cone, sorry. That gives us 1 over 3 pi. Then I'll use small letter R to represent what? The radius of the small cone. Then small letter H represents the height of the small cone. Can you see now? From here now, I can factor something out. 1 over 3 is here. 1 over 3 is here. I can factor it out. Let me factor it out. We have this of the bracket. Then pi is here. Pi is here. Let me factor it out again. So I'll be having capital letter R is minus small letter R square ish. So this is the volume of the what? Let me use this to represent the volume of the buckets,
which is the what? Volume of the first term of the code.
Hope that is clear to you now. For this diagram now, I want to do something here that is very, very important. So this thing, I want to draw it out. Let me draw it out. This is the what? You will say that this is the what? A triangle. Let me draw it out like this. Can you see it now? Can you see it now? So from here to here is 12. This way will be what? 12. Can you see it now? Can you see it now? And from here to here is radius. And it is what? It's 8. It's 8. It's 8 centimeter. And from here to here is how big? 20 centimeter. Then from here to here. Capital letter H. Let's also draw it here. Capital letter H. And this capital from here to here be what? From here to here plus from here to here. And this place is what? Small letter H. So from here to here be what? 20 plus H. Is that clear? So continue from here.